guys, we're back with my little princess. Anyway, Eva and Michelle, she's doing great. And she is thin. I'm just feeding her little small meals, though. I'm not trying to... Her stomach looks kind of pretty chubby. She might have had puppies before. Anyway, I'm just helping her understand that pagers, me communicating. And what it is that I'm trying to communicate. The table's ready. Your table's ready. And she will...
I got a little spongy side to her, though, I'm willing to bet. She started getting a little frisky yesterday. So that's how I reciprocate that. I don't rub the head. Oh my God, I think she knows tricks. I kept holding it down because she was in there.
Oh, and I'm getting mobbed.
Oh, I saw this thing online. It's on one of my Facebook groups. They have this place. I want to go there one day. It's in South America, I think. And they do birthday parties for dogs. And they did this movie where the guy kind of acted like Charlie Chaplin and did a whole, like, routine with the dog who's jumping on and doing all these tricks. I realized how poor our filmmaking was. Oh, I told him. It's unbelievably good. They'd had a shot it in black and white and did a whole movie reenacting like a Charlie Chaplin thing. Not my book. All right, so look, I'm going to hold my pager down. Holding it down, holding it down. I'm holding it, holding it, holding it. Holding it, holding it. Keeping holding, holding, holding. I'm holding. That's what you'd be ready to do. She does not know what that is. There's no disobey. I need to make it happen again real quick. Watch. Well, I'm using a different collar because I'm Martin went dead.
Because I didn't charge it.
I don't know what the charging cycle is like that. Yeah, but if you said that's hurting the dog, then I'd hardly. Hardly, it's making her happier than ever. You know, and I don't want to set the dog up at all. I want to wait until the dog... You gotta be kidding me. Well, let's go down.
Dog still.
Oh, let's just cut that out of the shot. Stay on this one, dog. Stay on this one. Again, it's not a punishment. She's going to get spotted. Watch. All right, look, here's my pager. Here's my pager. Holding it down, holding it down. This dog is naive to the collar. This is his second day. Second day with the collar. Let's go this way. We're going to leave him. And I do want to add my... You know that they're willing to just act freely. They don't feel like they have to watch. All right, you need to go swim. Your new mama wants to see you swim.
She looks like a half boxer, half English bulldog.
You know what I mean? One of those like George Bulldog type bulldogs. What did you do? I said, drove that dog back in my direction. Drove it back in my direction. I didn't call it and make it obey me. Oh, look at my little monkey shine. All right, I'm going to show you how I can help her understand it's me too. And I just don't have any reaction to that. There's no instructions for this little dog. Oh, we got trouble over here, though. Look, look, look. Oh, look at Sparkles. I see you over there, Sparkles. And if you think you're getting any cookies later at snack time, you're not, Sparkles. You're not. Your cookies are out. Go ahead and go. Go on, go. Your cookies are out. Sometimes her ears stand up like that. I don't know what kind of dog that would make you. What a cute dog. I call this little black bulldog. And this is only his second day, too. So I can tell you, he's starting to cause trouble. Uh-oh, look, look, he's got down on the roof. And I'll tell you what, you don't want to do anything to shut that down. All right, so I got my eye on that little black one. Andy! Yay! Oh, he's a good little dog. He drinks too much though, Summer. After you left, remember what happened before you left? Well, that happened to you after
you left. He did it again?
I just constantly make Summer empathize with my ridiculous situation here. Oh, no. All right, come on. Yeah, oh no. No, went over by the door. Well, I thought I heard water pouring.
I just thought it was our waterfall. Then we remembered we didn't have a waterfall.
You know, but if you want to be, you know, somebody to your dog, you honestly got to be part of this scenario. You know, if you're the person that stops, oh, look, put on that little black kit, look. Andy! You see, it brought that little deaf one, it brought that one too. This one. I told him with the pager, though. If you didn't said you didn't turn him with the pager, I said I'll do it again. Andy! That's the dog's second day. So you're never going to get it in your spot. Oh, let's all go for a little walk. All right, now I kind of got my eye on my little deaf one. And my bulldog there. Look at her go. Look at her go. Dixie! I want to safeguard that, and I'm going to tell you why. Because if I need to put some pressure on this dog, that's when I'm going to do it. When it's way over there, and I'm going to do it. Look, look, look. Andy! Yay. If you said you're not training him to come with that pager. Oh, my God! It's a fake show. All right, come on, let's go. So I'm thinking about my little deaf one here. I know I put a little rein on that one a little bit. He's after whoever he saw go around that corner, though, Birdie or whoever. Oh no, Sparkles. My very unloyal. All right, so I'll tell you what we do. See ya.
We don't want to be ya.
You have got to be kidding me. This episode is called
Pacific. All right,
look.
Oh, I got my eye on my pit bull, though, because look at that little black dog. We need to get some photos of them together. How cute are they? Oh, they are cute together. Yeah, they are.
You might like him, Steph. Look at Sparkles going in those bushes. Come on, let's go.
Let's go.
So you just controlled Sparkles, which is why. Begging him to come back to me. No, that probably wouldn't have worked. Pleading, begging. No, no.
Yes.
Yeah,
most certainly.
I'm going to be ready though, and I'm going to tell you what's going to get this pit bull and Nick. Farmer. is jutting off into those bushes real quick, like anything like that.
All finished. In a traffic jam.
There's my little deaf one. Get on that little deaf one. Watch. Holding it down, holding it down.
Run for it.
But this dog, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to tell you the key is going to be, this is how she's going to know you're a car-carrying member of the club. Because she is not playing the affable card. It's actually an affable dog. There is a difference. Guys, so you can see what this called me. These are electronic collars, and they're not what people think they are. If this is what they are, then let's all get one, because these are two rescue dogs that are naive. This is their second day with the collar. I'm going to get this little deaf one. Get on that little deaf one. Get a better shot when you're not behind the bush. Go down and follow it down. Don't let it see you. Michelle, you don't know this, but on the show, they don't go to bed. They don't go to bed. But what I'm saying to myself is I'm looking for a dog that's going away from me. Why? Because that's when I'm going to need a dog that can't hear me to come. And I also understand, I'm being very divorced. You're watching me that close already. Okay, there she is. She's being let off by Sparkles. Watch, holding it down, still holding.
We got a winner. Run for it.
And I'm going to show you what that got me though, a lot of speed. It tells me a lot though, and I'm going to tell you, Ricky, I hope you're watching this. What that tells me is this dog isn't that sensitive. But listen guys, we're going to go try to get a slow-mo of this little pit bull. And we'll do a short movie, be right back.